The minor injuries we suffer daily causes a quick response to scar and heal the skin. Shortly after, new cells replace the injured ones, and the wound becomes faint. In the brain, however, the matter is different, cause dead neurons have no replacement.
One day, my grandmother was cooking and suddenly a strong headache came over her. Everything turned white and she instantly lost consciousness.
2 days later, Mrs. Peterson woke up in the intensive care unit, realizing she had suffered stroke, a brain injury interrupting blood flow.
Her life changed dramatically since. She has a tricky time doing everyday activities, cooking or getting out of bed. Her left side does not respond as before. Luckily, I can support her when needed, and we learned to overcome many of the difficulties the injury brought.
At Jules du Québec of Université Laval, Dr. Daniel Manrique is a neuroscientist devoted to unrevealing how the brain heals and recovers from injuries.
After a brain injury, the neuronal data strongly impacts people's quality of life. But we have different cell types that quickly respond to aid the brain recovery to a certain degree.
Using mice to simulate stroke, Dr. Manrique explores how neuroglia, perivascular cells, astrocytes, pericytes, and microglia build a scar and contribute to recovery.
Overpassing the consequences of brain injury is challenging. However, our team has begun to elucidate the amazing potential that brain pericytes and neuroglia have for neurological recovery.
The use of transgenic mice allows Dr. Manrique to easily spot cell reactions to injury and explore the biological machinery implicated in scar formation. Using computational models to analyze the patterns of cell migration and arrangement in the injury areas provides some essential insights to portray alternative recovery routes.
Understanding how pericytes and neuroglia build a scar will allow us to develop novel therapeutic strategies. We can aim at controlling these cells and use them as instruments to help neurons reorganizing and establishing new functional networks. We can even analyze the genetic properties of single cells and reprogram them to become functional neurons. Every day we learn something new, and we are gradually approaching to a global understanding of the neurovascular response.